Hallelujah. Me and my sister Beluda, we stand here today in Campbelltown on beautiful Queen Street to declare the good news of Jesus Christ and to preach the message of salvation. Hallelujah. And we believe that many will come to the knowledge and the saving power of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Oh, Jesus is
glory.
God.
Amen.
Jesus is God.
Hallelujah. We glorify you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We come to you this day bearing good news. The wonderful message. We're here to preach the message of the gospel of Jesus Christ. You might ask, what is the gospel all about? Friends, the gospel is about God offering sinful people eternal life. We are all, amen, brother. God bless you. Hallelujah. We are all sinners in need of a Savior, and Jesus Christ is the Savior. Bless you, brother. Jesus loves you. Friends, the Bible says, for God so loved the whole world that he sent his only Son. Whosoever shall call upon the name of Jesus shall not perish, but shall receive everlasting eternal life. We encourage you today that there is power in the name of Jesus. Only Jesus can set you free. Salvation is found in no other name. It is only found in the name of Jesus. Many people seem to think that there's many roads to heaven, many pathways to heaven. Friend, that is a lie from the devil himself. There are not many roads to heaven. There is only one way. Jesus is the only way. Jesus said, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So I want to encourage you today, if you're hearing this message, that Jesus Christ is offering you salvation. He's offering you a free gift, which is eternal life. God has given you free will, friend. He will never, ever force his way into your life. And Jesus says, behold, I stand at the door and I knock. If anyone lets me in, I will come in and I will have supper and I will never leave you or forsake you. Jesus Christ wants to come into your life today. Will you open the door to him? In this life, many people are making and breaking appointments. But I'm here to tell you today that there is one appointment that cannot be broken. There is one appointment that cannot be broken, friend. And that's the day of judgment. The Bible says that every single one of us will have to stand before God on the day of judgment and give an account of the lives that we lived. The precious blood of Jesus Christ. How are you, darling? Bless you, bless you. The precious blood of Jesus Christ is the only thing that's powerful enough to wash away your sins. It's all about the blood of Jesus. So much power in the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. And I encourage you today not to ignore this message, but to call upon the name of Jesus. Friend, tomorrow is never guaranteed. People die every day without warning. No one knows when they're going to take their last breath. But I'm here today to tell you that if you die without Jesus, then you can never, ever enter the kingdom of heaven. If you wish to enter the kingdom of heaven, your sins must be washed clean with the blood of Jesus. The Bible says whoever calls on the name of Jesus, they will be saved. Jesus is the Savior that came from heaven to earth to die for the sins Jesus. The word of God says that no one knows of that day or that hour. But Jesus spoke of the signs and the seasons. He spoke about how there would be wars and rumors of wars. Jesus spoke about how there will be famine, disease, pestilence. Hallelujah, sister. Jesus loves you. Bless you, bless you. Keep looking up, sister. Your redemption draws near. Bless you. Have a good day. Jesus is our blessed hope. He is the hope of all glory. He is our blessed assurance. Hallelujah. That beautiful, precious name of Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus.
He is the King of Kings and He is the Lord of Lords.
Jesus.
He is the Alpha and the Omega. And He is the first and the last. And He is the beginning and the end. He is the great I Am. He is the Prince of Peace. He is the one who was dead, but He is alive forevermore. He is the I Am. He is Almighty God. Oh, Jesus.
Jesus.
He's so worthy to receive glory and honor and praise. Demons tremble at the name of Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Every knee will bow. And every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah.
You know somebody.
Glory. So I encourage you today, come to Jesus, friend. Time is running out. The rapture of the church can take place at any moment. Jesus spoke about a time when He would come back to rescue His people. When He descended, when He was ascending to heaven, He told His disciples that He's going to the Father's house and that He's going to prepare a place for us. And that in His Father's house, there are many mansions. He said that He's going to prepare a place for us, and one day He's coming back to take His faithful followers back to heaven so that where He is, we may be also. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is the hope that every born again, spirit-filled woman, man, and child of God has.
Jesus.
We don't put our hope in worldly things, in earthly things. We put our hope in Jesus because He is the one who set us free. He's the one that translated us from the kingdom of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of light. Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Woo!
Glory to Jesus.
We need to rejoice,
Jesus,
because He's coming back. And me and my precious sister Beluda, we stand here today to preach the good news to you because Jesus has commanded us to preach the good news. He's commanded us to be lights in this dark world. We encourage you today, if you're hearing this message, if you need prayer, come and we'll pray with you. If you want to invite Jesus into your heart, please do not hesitate. There's only one way to be saved. Jesus said you must be born again if you wish to enter the kingdom of heaven. Born of water and born of the Spirit. The Bible says that if you shall confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus is Lord and that God raised Him from the dead, then you will be saved. He didn't tell us that we have to confess to a priest. Confession to the priest is unbiblical. Jesus is the one that died for your sins. Only He can forgive you of your sins. I'm here today to tell you that Jesus loves you. He loves you so much that this King of Kings and Lord of He stepped away from his throne to come down to earth for one and one purpose only. He spread his arms out on a cross to be nailed to a cross because he loves you. That's how much he loves you. Bless you, sister.
Hallelujah.
Jesus loves you. Hallelujah. Jesus was rejected so that you and I could be accepted. Jesus was disgraced so that we could be given grace. He was bound in chains so that we could be set free. He was whipped and he was beaten so that by his stripes we would be healed.
Hallelujah.
And ultimately, he died so that you and I could live. That's how much Jesus loves you, friend. That he would rather die on a cross than live without you. There was a joy that was set before him when he hung on that cross. He knew that dying on that cross meant spending eternity with his creation. He had the power to lay down his life and to take up his life again. Hallelujah.
Oh, glory to Jesus.
We do not deserve this precious gift, but he loves us. God the Father loved us so much that he gave up his most valuable possession, his precious son, Jesus Christ. That's how much God loved you and me. But I'm here today to tell you that even you were the only person on the face of this earth. You matter to God. He would have still come down to die for you, my friend. And the question today is, what are you going to do with Jesus? This is the most important question that you could ever ask yourself. What are you going to do with Jesus? Eternity is hanging in the balance. There is a life, an eternity waiting for you and for me. There's two places, my friend. There's heaven and there's hell. Heaven is for those who acknowledge Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Heaven is for those who become born again and filled with the Holy Spirit. Heaven is for those whose sins are washed clean in the blood of the Lamb. Hell is for those who reject the Son of God. Unfortunately, hell is for those who don't want to go to heaven Jesus' way, but they try to make their own way. Friend, you can't get to heaven any other way. It's only through Jesus. It's only through the cross.
Amen.
It's only through the shed blood of Jesus Christ that you can enter the kingdom of heaven.
Oh, glory to Jesus.
Jesus did not come to condemn you. He came to save you. He came to set you free. He came to set the sinner free. Today, Jesus says to you, bless you. Today, Jesus says to you, to choose this day whom you will serve. For I set before you life and death. Whoever walks in me will never walk in darkness. So we encourage you today to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life. The Lord and Savior of your life. He has the power to heal you. He has the power to set you free. He has the power to deliver you. Jesus is his name.
Jesus.
Jesus. Only Jesus. No other name. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory. Jesus changed my life many years ago. And I'm not embarrassed to stand here and declare to the rest of the world how amazing he is. I'm not embarrassed of the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He set me free. He healed me. He delivered me. He pulled me out of darkness. And he filled me with his Holy Spirit. The joy and the peace that he gives. It's a peace that passes all understanding. That I want to share my Jesus with you in the hope that you will go running to Jesus. He can do for you what he did for me. I was lost and broken and helpless and hurting with nowhere to run. I had nowhere to go. There was no hope for me. But I cried out to Jesus. The Bible says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord, they shall be saved. I want to encourage you today. Cry out to Jesus. He's listening. Now is the time to cry out. Ask Jesus to forgive you. Now is the time to repent and turn from your sins. Because time is running out. You don't know when you're going to take your last breath. You don't know when Jesus is going to return. Today is the day of salvation. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. He can forgive you of every known and unknown sin. All he wants you to do is humble yourself. Come to him. Jesus says, come to me as you are. All other gods are the works of man's hands. But Jesus is the Most High God, and he is alive.
Glory.
All are people worshipping many gods, but those gods died. Those false prophets died, and they stayed dead. But Jesus rose on the third day,
hallelujah,
and he is seated in heaven at the right-hand side of God the Father, interceding for you and for me. Hallelujah.
Oh, glory to Jesus.
Today, I tell you that there is hope in Jesus. Doesn't matter who you are. Doesn't matter where you are, where you are in your life. It doesn't matter what you've done. Come to Jesus today. Jesus is offering you life-giving water. Whoever drinks the water that Jesus gives, you will never thirst again. Hallelujah.
Oh, amen.
Come to the living water that Jesus has to offer you.
Oh, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Oh,
not only is he the living water, but he's also the bread of life,
amen,
that came from heaven.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory.
Jesus loves you all. Have a blessed day today. And I encourage you, today ask Jesus into your heart. Humble yourself. And invite Jesus Christ to come into your heart.
Amen.
This is not a religion. Jesus is not my religion. Jesus is my Savior.
Amen.
Religion is following a set of man-made rules, man-made laws. Religion cannot change the person that you are. Religion doesn't have power to change you. When you come into a personal relationship with Jesus, the one that died and rose again, friend, he can save you, set you free for his glory. Amen. Hallelujah. Have a blessed day. Jesus is the answer.